He goes after it back in his own zone as the Flames make a change. Soleil, lead pass, picked up by Solani. He shoots, scores!
At the front of the net. Brindamore hands on back to Staal, then to Hedekin. Then Staal with a shot, knocked down in front by the defense, scramble for it there. Coming by Brindamore, he scores!
Carolina finds the puck right in front. Fitzpatrick didn't know where it was. Brindamore got there after Justin Williams created all the attention. And Brindamore, the captain, gives his team the lead. You see the reaction at the bench. It's a power play goal. Brindamore from the side sees loose puck. Fitzpatrick doesn't find it. Miller's deep. Top corner. Brindamore reads it, jumps in. Wham, top corner.
You see the energy Cole's brought to the line, though. Recchi's got better jumps, and Staal's got better jump, and it's all because of the play of Eric Cole.
Here's a big score!
From the faceoff, Jason Smith's on the puck, but Brindamore got in there and knocked the puck down. It stays alive, and Cabrelet through the screen, a big-time shot that finds the net. What a play by Rod Brindamore. Oh, the puck went off the hip of Jason Smith, and it changed speed and direction past Markkanen. What a play by Brindamore.
Back to Henrik. Salo, no shot there. Henrik Sedin. Daniels in the slot. Olin moves up, shoots. Linden tipped it. Scores! Timmer Linden tipped the puck in. Vancouver has the lead, 2-1.
Linden gets his 11th point in game sevens in his career. And you're going to see him 16 there, tip it, and it just went through the legs of Turco. And it's 2-1 Vancouver, and this joint's rumbling. You're right, Jim, when you mentioned earlier, they're winning faceoffs. And when you start with the puck, as often as Vancouver has in the second and this part of the third period, good things are bound to happen.
Roommates Matthias Olin and Trevor Linden probably mapped that out in a few days lounging, watching football games on the road.
In the last couple of games, he goes to the corner. Alex Kovalev moving on Chara, holding onto it, putting on a show here. Tomasarek awaiting a one-timer, it's tipped in! Held in front, the redirection! If it's not Tomasarek, it's Koivu! Montreal up and running!
Kovalev with puck possession, they move it around. It was out high, I believe, the deflection. Tomasarek with a big bomb. There's a deflection off the defenseman of the Boston Bruins, Tim Thomas. Not always the most...
down to Richards. Richards from Rio, the shot blocked. Punches back, team and in shot. Save, rebound. They score! They score! Jeffrey Lupo tucks it home, and the Flyers win game seven in overtime and head to round number two.
Hemo Timonen and launched the first shot, I believe, that Cristobal Huey lost sight of once it hit him. That's exactly what Joffrey Lupo needed. Here's Timonen's shot. Huey lost sight of it. He did not know where it was, but Joffrey Lupo did. And the Flyers dramatically advanced to the second round after giving away all of the momentum to the Cats in the series. They win it.
He'll get it off to the wing for Green.
The play is made down low. Ryan Klo working hard against two Flames, chips it out to the point. Erhoff waits, spots Greer coming in wide. Nobody picks him up, and that's enough of a block by Corey Saric. And that quick stick makes a nice play by blocking that play to the net. Pavelski with the quick stick on Nystrom. Lifts the stick and scores.
In the faceoff circle, LaRose trickle it ahead. Here comes Staal with it. Shooting, score! Staal with 31.7 to go in the third, and the Hurricanes lead.
To beat the Devils, will they do it again? Staal, I don't know if that hit Mike Motto or not, similar to the Ruutu goal, where again it's a left-handed shot coming down the right wing. and he fires it back against the grain.
It's on Dubinsky, a shot. He tried to go across the grain high on the stick side. Didn't miss by much. And back comes Sergei Fedorov now. Going wide on Redden. Here's Fedorov, puts on the brakes. Snaps a shot. He scores!
John Morrison couldn't get it deep, and Crosby off to the races. He's got Kunitz in tow. Crosby pulls up, drops it off. Guerin shoots and scores! Billy Guerin makes it 3-0, 28 seconds in.
Found the six hole, that spot between the arm and the body. Guerin makes that play to send Crosby in flight. He stops up. Nobody picks up Billy Guerin. Capitals have the men back. Look, you got to have your head on a swivel. Nobody does. And Billy Guerin stays in that soft spot, and he makes the Capitals pay.
Seidenberg up ahead for Whitney with Walker. Whitney shoots. Thomas, the rebound, score! Scott Walker! His first career playoff goal is the overtime winner in Game 7. Who is the overtime hero for the Carolina Hurricanes as they take it 3-2 in overtime in Game 7. Walker's first career playoff goal is one he will never forget. This has been a presentation of TSN, Canada's sports leader.
Lidstrom with a good shot from there, and he doesn't take it. Played in front, though. Lidstrom stopped it at the blue line and fed it in. Turning with it is Zetterberg. Zetterberg with Cleary in front of the net. Cleary poking it. He scores! Cleary has scored the go-ahead goal with 3 minutes remaining. His life. This is a close game, folks.
Well, Zetterberg with the puck recovery here. Look at Cleary in front of the net. He just holds his ground and then jams away. Prongers has him. And then Prongers more concerned here. It looks like, yep, against Zetterberg. And he doesn't switch with Bojeman. Gets left, is left wide open in front to deal with Cleary. And the puck, yes, squeaks over the goal line. With 3 minutes even to go. Ken Holland, pretty happy at the moment.
The whole town's happy at the moment.
6'7", 250-pound defenseman sees it played right back along by his defense partner, Scuderi. Swatted back out and a two-on-one developing. Moving in is Talbot up the wing. A shot! He scores! Max Talbot with two goals in the game, and it's 2-0.
Oh, that's all Brad Stewart again. Max Talbot's in his head.
Stop it right here. The pinch by Brad Stewart and then support. The two-on-one. Kunitz wins the battle. Hoodler comes over now a two-on-one. And then the quick shot over the glove of Chris Osgood. Maxime Talbot looks, gets to the top of the circle, and what I love is he keeps that puck in a shooting position. He doesn't get it in front of him. No stick handling. Gets it in that position. And look at Osgood. Boy, oh boy, he seemed like he was off his angle just a little bit. Interesting to see what Darren Pang's opinion of Osgood's positioning there. Off his angle a little bit. A lot of room on the glove side. But Kunitz with a great play in his own zone. Gets the penalty.